In this Ivanti video, I'm going to show you how to import organizational data, specifically business units, into License Optimizer. This will also give us a quick overview of how data import works in License Optimizer. Here is a cut-down version of the business unit structure that we want to set up. This company has a presence in the UK and the US, with two sites in the UK and three in the US. Focusing on the UK, we see that both sites have an engineering department, and that the Bracknell engineering department has two teams. We're going to import this structure using a spreadsheet. When you import business units using License Optimizer, you can also specify a business unit code, a business unit type, and a parent business unit for each business unit that you import. This ability to associate a parent business unit enables us to build the business unit structure using our spreadsheet. Let's take a look at the spreadsheet I've created for the business unit structure that we want. I've included a deliberate mistake so that I can show you an additional feature later on. I've not included a business unit code in my example, but that's not the deliberate mistake. Row 1 is the header, and I've called the columns business unit name, parent business unit, and business unit type. You can call them whatever you like, but these names mean that the mapping between the spreadsheet and the License Optimizer database will be done for us automatically. Row 2 is the first business unit, UK. It has no parent business unit, meaning that it will appear at the top level under the company. Row 3 is the next business unit, Bracknell. This has UK as the parent, as does row 4, Darsbury. Row 5 adds USA at the top level, and rows 6, 7 and 8 add the three sites under the USA. Rows 9 and 10 add engineering departments under Bracknell and Darsbury, and row 11 adds a UK team 1 under the Bracknell engineering department. Row 12 is my deliberate mistake. I haven't specified a parent for UK team 2. See if you can predict what's going to happen with that row. Then we can fix it after the import. Right, let's get started. First thing, let's just check that I'm not importing business units that already exist. In License Optimizer, click Business Units under Configuration. At the bottom of this page, UK and USA aren't there, so let's import them using my spreadsheet. Under Data Management, click Data Import. The Data Import page has two sections, which correspond to different methods of data import. The Connector Types section enables you to configure a connector using the Ivanti Cloud Agent, but we are going to use one of the tiles under Import Types. Click Organizational Data. The Organization Data Sources page enables you to manage the import of your organizational data, both business units and locations. Each row in the data grid corresponds to an existing data source. We're going to create a new data source, so click New Organizational Data. The Create New Organizational Data Import page appears. Type a name for the import. I'm going to name it for myself, although my real surname isn't Test. And in the organizational data type list, select business unit list. Then select the business unit list checkbox under select your sources. Click save. The business unit list page appears. Here we find and upload our spreadsheet. Click select, find your spreadsheet, and then click upload. Click next. The map business unit list page appears, where we can map columns in our spreadsheet to columns in the License Optimizer database. Because we named our columns with the appropriate names from the License Optimizer database, the columns are already mapped for us. If you click Preview Data, a new window appears showing you what will be imported. Click Next. The Settings page appears. In the Import Method drop-down, click Merge, which is the only option. This means that the data in your spreadsheet will be merged into the existing data in License Optimizer. Click Save and Test Import. The Test Import page appears, reporting that the import files were validated OK. From here, we can either test the import or queue it. Let's select the Commit checkbox and click Run Test. This will test the import and commit the first 100 records to the License Optimizer database. This will be all of our business units. For larger imports, it makes more sense to queue or schedule the import. The data is imported, and the Test Import page refreshes, reporting that the import is complete. Use the drop-down to select Import Business Unit to see the data that has been imported. Now let's go and check the Business Units page. Under Configuration, click Business Units. At the bottom, you can see UK and USA. We can expand them to see the structure that we hoped for. Between UK and USA, you can see UK Team 2 at the top level. This was our deliberate mistake in row 12. No worries, we can fix that now. Click and drag UK Team 2 to Engineering BRK. The tree updates. Thank you for watching this Ivanti video. I hope you found it useful. For more information, please visit help.ivanti.com.